Good afternoon, everybody on YouTube. It's Rick Thomas from Obsolete Video Services. Today, I just got in a 3/4-Yamatic VO7600. Okay, folks, I do an awful lot of these, and I just want to make a point to a lot of people out there who buy these off eBay. Please, folks, when you buy these off eBay and you're spending all this kind of money on these things, if they don't work, the only person you could blame is yourself. I feel really bad for people who buy these off eBay because they never do work. I mean, every time you get them, they have to be serviced. This thing needed belts, which is the easy part of it all. Putting brand new belts in this is a snap. But also it had bad loading carriage issues. Biggest problem is it had a bad video card on the top, which I did have a spare, which this guy is very, very lucky. I had a spare from a machine I tore apart not too long ago, kept it for parts. So I was able to replace the upper video board, which now gives us video output, as you can see. So the video card on this sweet thing was shot, and they do go bad, folks. So you do need to troubleshoot your cleaning your video heads, your connectors. Anything could cause that. The video card, filthy video heads, bad connections, bad wires. So you need to really troubleshoot when you work on these if you're not getting any video output. But in this case, unfortunately, it was the actual video card, which I did have a replacement, and he was very, very lucky because, you know, I get so many of these machines. When I gut out some real garbage ones, I keep several cards that I know down the road are going to be needed. And this happens to be one I had in my inventory that he actually did need. So pop that sucker on and voila, we now have video. See, Obsolete Video Services kind of troubleshoots everything, and that's why it hangs on various different parts. Because, like, perfect example, like this type of thing, a video card, you can't just run down to the local electronics store and pick one of these up. But if I had this in my inventory, a bunch of other cards, and I mark them what models they come off of, and 9 times out of 10, I'll end up needing to use it. And like an example, like this particular one, very, very bad card. It was just putting out black, probably most likely the processing IC on it. Not worth going through the trouble of trying to repair it. I just swap it out. And but anyways, you got a video output card. You know, it was bad. We changed that. Put brand new rubber belt kits on this thing, cleaning and lubrication alignments. And now we're just doing some fundamental type of testing to make sure everything's working. The meter guide is working. All the audio meters are working. And we are getting video output. So this was probably about an hour repair, not even that. I was able to troubleshoot the issue. He told me he got this thing, it just didn't have any video output, and in a lot of cases it's something simple like a dirty video head, broken video head. That's the first thing you look for. But once you get to that point, and you know, and that's not the issue, it ends up being your output video card, which is the very top card on this unit. That's your output video output. When those cards go bad, you get no video, but unfortunately, I happen to have one in inventory and was able to fix this disaster, so that way the machine isn't junk. In most cases, this machine would be complete garbage without a couple spare part machines to fix, to build one, but since I happen to have the card in inventory, he was very lucky and I was able to repair the machine. So here's a VO7600, bad video output card, completely serviced with belts, lubrication, alignment, and everything else. We're just doing the troubleshooting on it now. Video output is good. It's playing video. And voila, guys. Chuck up another VO7600. I work on hundreds of these, folks. If you got 3/4-Yamatic machines, you need them serviced. I know it's kind of expensive to ship these, but, you know, in the long run, if you send them to me, I can turn them around pretty quick. I pretty much troubleshoot these probably within the first half hour because I work on so many of them. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video.